In May 2018, the EU introduced a new regulation designed to protect data of all EU citizens. This regulation replaced existing data protection laws in all EU countries. The name? GDPR, short for General Data Protection Regulation. Every organization in the EU was affected by this regulation, and so was every organization outside looking to do business within the EU. When I came to Germany to understand the workings of this regulation, I had several questions in my mind. One of the loudest was, what does this mean for enterprises which do not operate on the same level as big corporations? What about the little guy? So I looked harder for answers. The crux of GDPR is protecting the movement and processing of personal data belonging to natural persons of the EU. People like you and me, who have certain rights over our own personal information. And that requires significant changes in organizations which undertake the processing and movement of data. Sounds easier said than done. For several small and medium-sized enterprises, this is a significant challenge, since they do not necessarily have the means to achieve this, or the method to maintain. These organizations operate with uncomplicated planning and operation systems with non-standard procedures. This is a big roadblock for implementing GDPR, since the regulation itself demands nothing less than absolute control of all functions which deals with personal data. What must a small, medium-scale organization do then? The short answer is, protect the rights of people giving their data to you. In May 2019, EU's GDPR compliance wing wanted to find out how up to speed are the SMEs with GDPR preparation. Turns out, not so much. They found out that approximately half were not compliant on two major requirements. A, explaining how the data is processed by them in a simple, uncomplicated manner, and B, explaining the lawful basis for using personal data. Another thing they found out was that around 1,000 euros was spent by 27% of SMEs towards GDPR compliance, another 10,000 euros was spent by 24% SMEs, and it was only 10% of SMEs which had not spent anything to comply with GDPR. But this cost wasn't all that bad. The ones who had spent money on their compliance efforts felt much more confident when handling data without hampering their growth. The jury was out on what they believed interested regulators. Some believed they're too small to be bothered with, and many other considered being fined as the motivation to comply. GDPR clearly requires every organization to reassess their data protection process, check for total compliance, and rework on the non-compliant bits. Having said that, it isn't unheard of that SMEs believe they get a free pass from the maze of GDPR because of their size or number of employees. Let's refresh the basics a bit. GDPR is based on 7 key principles. Number 1, lawfulness, fairness, and transparency. That is, process the data in a way that makes it easy to understand why, how, and what you are doing with the data. Number 2, limitation of purpose. Process data only for its intended purpose. This purpose must be clear and legitimate. Number 3, data minimization. You should only collect the data you need. Number 4, accuracy. Your data must be accurate and kept up to date. Inaccurate data should be erased or corrected. Number 5, storage limitation. You can only keep the data for as long as the purpose isn't completed. The only place this does not apply is for using in scientific, statistical, or historical research. Number 6, integrity and confidentiality. This is where security lies. Make sure the data is securely processed and safe from any harm or any unauthorized hands. Finally, number 7, accountability. You should be ready to show your compliance when required. GDPR does not look at the size of the company, but their data protection practices. So to know if you need to be worried, just ask these 3 questions. A. How much data does your company process? B. What kind of data it processes? And C. How does it process this data? The answer will help you know if you need to appoint a data protection officer or not. While fines have been a big compliance motivator, The concern is not limited only to SMEs. CNIL, a French National Commission for Informatics and Liberties, fined Google €50 million and €204 million to British Airways. On the other hand, SMEs such as Sergic was fined €400,000. Another fine was issued by the Polish Data Protection Authority to Quick Click Now for €47,000. GDPR wants to make sure SMEs comply with it, and there have been developments in this field beyond the standard contractual clauses. Development number one, the Court of Justice of the European Union stated in the Facebook case that companies running fan pages on Facebook or having Facebook-like button attached to their website are to be considered joint controllers of data. Development number two. Earlier, EU's data was processed by American companies according to Privacy Shield, but this has been also replaced by GDPR. Development number three. In May 2020, the EU updated that cookie walls should not be used, and accessing websites does not mean the user consents to cookies. You need express consent. Development number four. Big tech companies like Google and Apple face several antitrust lawsuits for exploiting their market position. This was triggered by complaints on the same issue by publishers and ad techs. But what does this mean for companies outside the EU? The connotation for these companies is the same as the ones within the EU. If you process EU's personal data, you have to comply with GDPR. And if you fail to do this, your assets in the EU will be taken. If you're not in the EU, you will have to have representation and you will be fined through them. You may also face international lawsuits. All this just goes to show how valuable data is. If your compliance efforts have been beyond legal compliance, this regulation will mean more opportunities and more customers. When GDPR was disclosed in 2016, it seemed as if there is enough time to take the steps for compliance. But that time has passed and several SMEs are still struggling. So if you haven't started already on your journey to compliance, I urge you to start now. Find time to figure out what needs to be done to be compliant. You can use tips from this talk to get started. Make a plan of action with milestones to ensure your business is safe and compliant.